Enemy spotted. Clean kill.
Yo, what is going on, guys? Hope you guys enjoy those clips. And today's video is my max rank 156 highlight video. In today's video is just my max rank, my combat record, my kills and accuracy for my snipers, my sensitivity, my settings, everything you need to know how to get the best settings for your sniping, as well as red gunning and everything. So first off, I'm gonna go through my class setup, show you guys my why I use my perks, my field upgrades, and everything with my tactical and lethal. The first class I have is my Road to Damascus class. I'm using the ARs right now. My next video is gonna be my SMG Platinum video, so definitely stay tuned for that. My first Road to Damascus video, so I hope you guys show some love on it when I upload that Thursday. So I mean, a lot of you guys can show some love on it. Then second class, AX50 Magnum EOD Hardline Tune-Up. You guys don't know what EOD is, it's basically Flat Jacket from previous CODs. Hardline, I use that to get my Specialist streak faster. Tune-Up is used for field upgrades to get those faster. So for like attack insert, dead silence, stopping power, very, very, very needed, in my opinion. Then throwing knife, I'm gonna be making a video on that as well, on why I use that in my class setup. And stem shot, just so I could heal up faster if I get shot. HDR, same thing with the class setup. Dragon off, very good in my opinion. Same thing, at car 98, same thing. Moving on to the field upgrades, I use the stopping power round just for Road to Damascus. Usually I run dead silence and attack insert, but just to get the Road to Damascus out of the way, I've been using stopping power rounds just to destroy them faster with the red guns, especially the attack insert. I usually just run that for sniping to get into spawns faster, and also Road to Damascus video just to get more kills with red guns, because I gotta get these camos fast. But for kill streaks, I use Harrier, Pablo, and Advanced UAV. Advanced UAV, wish it lasted longer in this game, but hey, still better than no Advanced UAV. It's basically like a hater from BO3. Then Harrier and Pablo, you guys already know what it is. It's Lurie from MW2. Very, very OP. Probably just as OP from MW2 as well. But moving on to the combat record, my weapon of choice is just M4 for now. Don't know why it's not the AX50, because I do have like more kills in it, as you guys can see right here. 1,261, KD 1.81, accuracy 56, headshot 228, death 698. Don't know why it still shows the M4, just because I was getting that for my Road to Damascus series. You need to get a lot of kills for the M4 and any AR, in my opinion, for Road to Damascus. It's like 1,000 plus kills. And time played, 2 days, 23 hours, 44 minutes. I'm a slob. 647 game played. KD 2.45. It got up a lot using the red guns. Like, the red guns are probably the most overpowered thing in any Call of Duty. It was like 1.345-ish when I was sniping. Then killstreak 61. Like, I got that for the MP7. MP7, you'll see that in my Platinum SMG videos. I'm doing my best class setups for the SMGs. And honestly, that MP7 class setup is probably the best MP7 class setup I've ever seen in my life. And wins. My first Call of Duty that actually have a positive win-loss ratio. Surprisingly, I don't know how, I've been raging a lot, but red gunning, you'll get a lot of wins, especially in TDM. So the rank progressions, I'm almost to, like, I think it would be the icon for the season. I have 6 stars right now, about to get my 7th, 8th, 9th, and 10th. Really cool how they do this, but I wish it was just normal prestige icons. But I'll definitely be getting that in Road to Damascus. I'm going to get 100% on this game, because in my opinion, this could be probably the most grinding Call of Duty I've ever played in my life. And I'm ready for the challenge, man. I'm really ready for the challenge. You guys have seen a lot of videos. Can't wait to show you guys all the videos I've been working on. I'll be showing you guys my settings, and like, if you guys want to copy all my brightness, my field of view, you guys play on PC, you guys could copy all of it. So I'll be showing you guys right now. Field of view 80 default, brightness 50 default. Everything is completely default right now. And I don't have colorblind. I don't know if it helps, but let me know in the comments if you guys think I should turn that on, just to make it easier to see the kill feed. I heard it makes a difference, but I don't know. I'm moving on to audio. So I use Audio Mix Boost High. It's the best audio in my opinion. Let me know if it makes a difference for you guys down in the comments, because in my opinion, it's probably the best one, just for personal preference. Master volume, default 100. Music volume 0. Dialogue volume 0. Just for time being, because like, all your character says in this game is like contact something, and it's very annoying. So effects, default. Everything's default. The rest is default. Then controller, we move on to the sensitivity. 12, 12, 1, 1 for ADS high zoom and low zoom. Basically the same thing for like, I think This is probably my best sensitivity I feel comfortable with, but I might be making a video for FOV, so let me know, and I'll put it to max sensitivity. Let me know if you guys want that. And aim assist standard, then aim response curve type dynamic. I heard dynamic is like the best one. In my opinion, it is, definitely is, and I honestly think this is probably the best one. Weapon mount activation is always disabled unless I want to get mounting kills with snipers, red guns, and just to get camos. That's the only time I turn it on is when I'm going for camos. So that pretty much wraps all the sensitivity and max rank and everything I've been getting so far with max rank. I'm having my first Road to Damascus video Thursday, so if you guys could show a lot of love on that, that would mean a lot. Be platinum SMGs, be showing you all my class setups for every SMG, and just a bunch of clips, tac nukes, because I have a lot of tac nukes in that video, with like almost every SMG in that video, so it's gonna be amazing. Hope you guys enjoy the video, it does mean a lot. If you guys enjoy the rest of the video as well, I do appreciate all your guys' support, so I hope you guys have a great day, great night, and thank you guys so much for insane amount of support. I really do appreciate all you guys, all the new subscribers. Thank you for just giving me a chance. It really does mean a lot. Have a great day, great night. Peace out. Love you guys. And I'll see you guys in my next video. Peace.